plant pot heaters. Which design is the best? These plant pot heaters here are configured one pot, two pot, three pot. So we'll put that in perspective. They're built to an identical design. So if we remove the dome nut, which I pre-loosened, remove the plant pot, and you can clearly see there's, well, you can see there's room for this plant pot, and then another one, and then this pot over that. So the one on the right is the triple, and the twin, and the single plant pot. The object of this experiment is to establish which one of these Cornish heaters, as they're also known as, will be giving the best output. We're going to be taking temperature readings of the dome nut and the side. And also, to make things a little bit more interesting, I'm going to be placing a candle, a large candle, at close proximity to these tea light heaters, so you can hopefully visually see how much heat is radiated from the heater, and it should melt the wax if we're lucky. Will it melt the wax? I don't know. Each tea light heater will be powered by these tea light candles available from a very well known furniture store. These are 4-hour candles, they're quite a good value. £5 for 100 is the current price. So, in order to even the test out, I'm going to have to light one candle on each in turn. Well, that's all six of each candle's lit. I've actually used one of these on a side note for a while. We've been through a few hundred candles with one of them in the living room, and I've never had any issues. There are a few videos scaring you off them. One thing we do is keep it well attended, and I would urge you to be extremely cautious if you plan on using one of these tea light heaters. Just keep careful and diligent. So, candles have been lit now, a couple of minutes, and that one, I'm feeling a bit of heat, not on that one. That's a single, that's interesting. And it's time to take some temperature readings. I'm planning to do it every 15 minutes, but this one will be a little bit askew. I've got a thermal camera there. Yeah, it's going up. The maximum temperature is 87 Fahrenheit. So the single, looking like it's going to warm up quicker. This is the double, at 65. And the triple is at 65. That's an anomaly. Yeah, there don't seem to be much in the double and the triple. The single's rocketing all the way up to 92. While the double's lagging behind in the 70s, 73. The triple has hit the 80s. That's interesting. Double's in the 80s. We could go on forever like this. I'll wait a bit, come back to them. I just thought I'd state that this is warm to the touch. I can feel this. The double, not. And neither is the case with the triple. The dome nut test. Can't feel any heat there. There. Or there. We're now 15 minutes into the test and the single is getting really hot. I can really feel that. And also the dome nut, it's very difficult to touch. Where the double, starting to get warm, I can easily touch the dome nut, but I can feel some heat on it. And the triple, strangely enough, it's much the same story. So let's take some readings. We've got a temperature in Fahrenheit maximum 267 is the highest figure I can read. And the dome nut 181. That's the single. Now the double 123 Fahrenheit. And the dome nut 96. The triple, 168 was the highest reading I saw, and the dome nut, 83. The idea of these heaters is to heat the air in between, not the the pot. So, I think most of the wax is starting to melt now, so that's great. And it may be time to introduce another element to the experiment in the form of the candles. And I think I'll place them 20 centimetres away and perhaps alter the camera position so you can see it clearly. So I've adjusted the position so you can see things a little clearer. We'll set all three of them approximately 20 centimetres away. I'm not really expecting any wax to melt at this stage. I can always be surprised. So we'll just move the candles in to 15. 15 centimetres. I don't think we're in any danger of melting them yet, but we're going to keep getting closer. The wax in most of the candles, with the exception of this one, has completely melted. I really should stop doing that. I can see this one for some reason hasn't took as well as its friend. I don't know why. There's a little bit of residual unmelted wax in that one. So we're now 45 minutes in. All the wax is liquid in the tea light candles on every one. And the first one, still really hot, that's the single. Ow. The dome nut is really hot too. And the twin, that's getting warmer, but not as warm as its single friend. And the triple feels more or less the same as the double. So let's just take some readings. Okay, the single coming in 195 degrees Fahrenheit on the side. On the top, 213 is the maximum reading. So I will then go to the double. 163 was the highest I've seen. And the top, 141. The triple, strangely enough, 166 for the side. And the dome nut, 132. So it's now time to shunt all these in slightly, and we're going to go into 10. I still don't think that there is any danger of them melting. So we're now 1 hour into the test, and all the wax is totally melted, and we'll just check some temperatures. Roughly, this one is too hot to touch. That's the single. The donut, ooh, crikey. The second one, nice and warm. I can handle that. Donut, quite hot. That's the hottest part. And the treble, similar place to the double. So, surface temperatures, just depends exactly where you point it at. It's obviously warmer near the candle. If I point it here, you can see we can get into temperatures in the 370s, 80s. Then we go higher up and it cools down. So I'll point it at the middle. 197 Fahrenheit. Dome nut, that's even hotter. 215. Again, we'll aim for the centre. 182. Dome nut. 145. Interestingly enough, the treble, 204 in the centre. And the dome nut, 143. Strange that. I'm going to repeat that. I'm not happy with that. 172 is the highest reading I've had. So we're now going to move the candles in to 5 centimetres. And see if anything's in danger of melting. In case you're wondering, I tend to just do it approximately for the benefit of the video, and then I'll fine tune it off camera just so these are something like right for the minute. Okay, we're now 2 hours into the test and none of the candles are anywhere near melting, but this one remains the hottest, the single, and that one seems to have warmed up actually, the double. And the triple, they're all very hot. Too hot really for me to touch, so let's take some readings from the middle. We had a maximum of 204 then, the dome nut. Maximum of 184. A maximum of 218. 163. The treble. Wow, we've got another high reading here. See if it holds. 242. And the dome nut, 168 then, it just flashed to. The treble's looking really good. Okay, well it's now time to get serious, and since we've got these at 5 centimetres, we want to move them inwards. Now I've pre-measured this. If I go all the way in, it's 2.5 centimetres. To the best of my knowledge, we're getting really close now. So we'll see if we have any candles melting. So we're now 3 hours into the test, and we'll start by checking the temperature of the single one. 247 was the most I saw. And the twin, or the double, 258 was the most I saw there. And the triple, 294, 96. Ooh, keeps getting higher. The triple is definitely the hottest one of the bunch. I can definitely tell you that no candles were harmed during the filming of this experiment. So what I think the best thing to do is remove the candles and we'll get the thermal camera and measure the temperature of the tops, hopefully, so you can see at home. So we'll start with a single. Hundred and 91 I saw there. The maximum temperature displayed. And the double. That one's a little bit cooler for some reason. I don't know why. 173. And the triple. The triple seems hotter than the double. Interesting. 184. So that concludes the experiment. Why not subscribe to view more experimental plant pot heater videos as I think of them. Use plant pot heaters at your own risk, and I think that's me covered as far as the disclaimer goes. Thanks for watching. Please like and subscribe.